A simple talk about radio coils and the question in this video is why do certain coils, radio coils, antenna coils especially, look braided? You can see that, how that looks like. It is in a certain way, it looks at least in a certain way as a kind of sloppy wiring of the radio coil. And this is an original antenna coil for long wave. And well, it was made with so-called Litze wire. And that's also an important thing. Litze. That means that we have approximately 30 windings, 30 separate wires. In the end they are soldered together, and also here they are soldered together, and that has everything to do with the so-called skin effect. That means when we are talking about radio coils, there is a general theory that the energy of the radio wave moves over the skin of the wire. And you can certainly see on Wikipedia or whatever what that means in practice. That means that not the whole copper wire is used to transport the energy, but only the skin of the copper wire. And to prevent that, they have, say, made here 30 wires, extremely thin. I surely, as a radio amateur, cannot make such a Litze wire. Of course I can make it when I was able to entwine, for instance, this type of wire, but that's more or less impossible, and that's also the reason why in my radio experiments I use the wire that I always name as ape hair wire. And here another coil that I'm working on for the long wave radio. But perhaps it was interesting to show some important radio phenomenon from the past. The skin effect, the Litze wire, and it's braided. Why is it braided? Well, there are some explanations. When you have, for instance, such a coil, there is, of course, inductance here caused by all the windings. That's completely logical. But there's also capacitance, and that capacitance is a kind of natural capacitance between all these windings. Between winding 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 10, etc., etc., there is a natural capacitance. So that means that such a coil is not only a pure inductance, but there's also a natural capacitance parallel to it. And even when there is no, say, tuning capacitor here, normally there's often a tuning capacitor here, there is a natural inductance. And of course, that depends on the classical radio theory, etc. The distance between the wires, the distance plays a role, the material inside the wires plays a role. So here's one wire, here's another wire, and there is isolation material in between that plays a role. And in general, that is, at least for shortwave, not very, very important, but for long wave and medium wave, that is a kind of issue, because you need more windings to get to the lower frequencies. More windings also means more, say, natural capacitance, even when there is no tuning capacitance there. You see another example. Of course, there will be natural capacitance here. Say, I think, did not measure it, it's perhaps difficult to measure it. I never made a test setup, but anyway, I think when I look alongside this coil, could be, for instance, the natural capacitance could be, for instance, 10 picofarad, or 50, or perhaps 20 picofarad. And of course, when we are talking about such a coil, all these windings are very, very close together. That means that such a coil has a quite high internal capacitance, natural capacitance. And the problem is that when you want to make a radio, that natural capacitance plays a role, of course, but on the other hand, that's, say, the classical radio theory. When you have a coil that's paralleled with a capacitor, and let's now say that that is the natural capacitor, so not the external capacitor, that means that such a coil has so much internal capacitance all over all these windings, that the bandwidth of such a coil, say, gets more broad. And we know in the radio theory, when the L factor is high, so many windings, and the C factor is low, you get a sharper peak on a certain frequency. That's logical. I don't want to get into all the formulas, but that's, say, a kind of classic rule, electronics rule. That means when the natural capacitance is also high, you have a broader bandwidth, so you have to, in a certain way, skip out the natural bandwidth, natural capacitance. I was a little bit distracted because I wanted to add a time tag. Anyway, so that's a reason why these coils are braided. I want to reverse the piece of paper now here to show in a better way how that works. I have also, of course, found this in the book, but anyway, here's the coil. Here is the form of the coil. Say, we stick in a ferrite rod into it. That could be done. It's not strictly necessary, because this, of course, is classical radio theory, and it relies to everything. When all the windings here are very properly neat and close together, you have between all these windings the capacitance. The natural capacitance. So this is one winding, and here, etc., etc. And say this is the classical example. All, there's all capacitance here. But when you make the coil in another way, say a sloppy, more or less sloppy wiring, and of course I forgot to tell that here is another layer, and so the capacitance gets more and more and more and more. But when you wind all these windings in this way, and let's say the braided, what we see here, the internal capacitance, say the natural capacitance of such a coil is substantially lower. So lower natural capacitance. And that's why you see in old school radios, high quality radios of the 1950s, the 1940s, etc., etc., this idea did originally come up in the 1920s, when they made the so-called honeycomb coils, also say a way to make such a coil less sensitive for natural internal capacitance. And you can do that yourself. Say take a piece of cardboard and then braid all these wires. That has also a very good effect on the coil, because the resonance peak gets sharper. And of course, go to the World Wide Web when you want to know more about this issue. Honeycomb coils, surely you will find information on the World Wide Web. And finally, well, again, this beautiful, beautiful braided coil with that ferrite rod inside. And because there is less capacitance, the tuning, when the say the ferrite rod is moved inside, that coil gets very, very sharp. Because there is, in a certain way, no stray capacitance. And of course, this can be also be found in many books, radio technology books, etc., etc. And of course, when you want to make yourself a coil with less natural stray capacitance, you can do these windings, this type of windings. And I couldn't do that, it's too complicated for me, but anyway, I will try to get more or less the same results with my homebrew coils for long wave. Thanks for watching, wish you luck. These are more or less the essentials.